And so for this session, last presentation, but also not least, I would like to invite Estonian Environment Agency, Kairi Vint, and she's going to talk about Estonian forest and agriculture soil monitoring story map.
Hello. Hello, everyone. My name is Kairi. I work at the Estonian Environment Agency in Weather Observation Department. I prepare climate maps, for example, average temperature anomalies, precipitation anomalies, sunshine duration, etc. 16 years ago, I started with ArcMap 3.3. Today, my main Esri tools are ArcGIS Pro and ArcGIS Online. By the way, change to the portal coming soon. Six years ago, in 2018, Estonian Environment Agency launched the first ArcGIS story map, environmental state of city Tartu. Story map won the prize in Estonian Esri user competition. Same year, in 2018, I attended the GIS online training. After that, step by step, I started preparing our annual meteorological yearbook in story maps. I wanted to say that I initiated preparing because we prepare all together in Weather Observation Department team. Our meteorological annual book was before in PDF files only. People in Weather Observation Department came happily along with the idea, and some people also attended Alpha GIS online trainings. And after hard work in March 2020, we launched our next meteorological yearbook as a story map for the first time. On the slide, you can see our first story map. It continues. For example, here you can see some screenshots about our latest meteorological yearbook. Next slide shows the areas of activities in Estonian Environment Agency. We have many departments. Other departments launched own topic story maps very fast, almost same time, with a tempo that mushrooms grow after rain. Very often, different story maps links were divided by different news. And we faced new challenge how to find the right story maps at the right time. This is where ArcGIS Hub platform comes in. We collected all story maps into the hub. In 2021, our hub site won the prize, the best web map in Estonian Esri user competition. Now I jump in with the soil monitoring story map. We launched it in September last year. After the launch, a lot of positive feedback came from Estonia and Europe, despite the fact that it was in Estonian language. Or who already knows how to generate story map? Those already understand me if I say it needs great investment, time, of time. And on the other hand, it is really a creative process. On the slide, you can see all the people behind the soil story map. Why soil monitoring story map? It introduces the national environmental monitoring programs, including soil. It gives a general overview of the monitored soil indicators in Estonia. And why soil monitoring? Soil provides important nature benefits, which includes good functioning of ecosystems, food safety and food security. The aim of soil monitoring is to explain and understand the changes of conditions in the soil and monitor the impact of human activities on the soil. On this slide, you can see all the monitored elements divided by field, forest, and integrated type. For example, one map from the soil monitoring story map, it's comparison map. On the left side is land use, on the right side is soil classification map layer. The monitoring areas are divided by the monitoring location type, forest, field, and integrated. The swipe tool gives opportunity to look what type of soil we see under the specific land use. For example, in case of bog area, we expect peat type soils. Here on the map, instead of points, we use trees and corn symbol. And here, just next to the comparison map, is possibility to download map as a PNG file. This is land use, and this is a soil classification map. Next, ArcGIS map tour, Estonian soil types. When you click on the type of soil picture, the point on the right-hand side map takes you to the monitoring location where this type of soil can be found. Next, forest monitoring sites, very detailed map with lot of information about measurements, soil layer photos, and all the measured elements, bar charts. Organic carbon stock in Estonia, also interactive map and possibility to download PNG file. And last chapter in soil story map is all the links to the other story maps or videos, books, and link to environmental portal. To sum up, year by year, the number of story maps has grown in Estonian Environment Agency. And story map creation is a very creative process and a good possibility to make your information attractive to public. I wish you good luck in telling your stories in Esri story maps. And I show some minutes also the real hub platform where we collected all the story maps. The title, the hub is Estonian Environmental Agency story maps. And all the story maps are here. And it's important to notice that below the site is possibility to download all the map layers if it's made public. For example, shape files and everything. Next, I briefly show our meteorological story map. for example, meteorological overuse. There is about 50 maps, climate maps, month by month. Also using swipe. Swipe is here, yeah, values is coming. Here is compared to normal, for example, precipitation sums compared to normal. And finally, our soil story map. Step by step, I saw again this comparison map. And map tour. It's loading. If you click on the soil type, it shows you where it is found. Also, I tried to find this forest monitoring map. You can check it, it's very detailed. Every pop-up contains the photos and the chart bars. And final part is publications. And here we have videos about soil. And that's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Kairi. Thank you. There are some questions popping up. So, what is the main auditory who are using these maps you create?
Universities, other institutions, I hope.
I see. And do you have any statistics who is or which one is the most popular one?
No, not yet, but we will prepare this maybe.
Okay, and on my side, I would like to ask, did you, like, when you were creating these story maps, did you find something unexpected while working, something that like surprised you or your colleagues
or data or
data analyze doing some analyze, because you, when you create story maps,
I don't know at the moment.
Okay. So, by the way, thank you, Kairi. And
thank you.
If you noticed.